I'm Sean Slevin. I'm a licensed professional counselor and licensed marriage and family therapist.
All right, I'm Basil DeJohn.
Now I'm Connie DeJohn, his wife of many, many years.
Oh, God. Just answer the questions. This isn't a joke. Yes, we've been married 56 years.
I'm Vesley.
I'm Brooke Vesley.
And we were married on May 23rd, 2021.
I'd be coming right back home to you. I think I might.
I think we are. Yeah, no doubt we are. And I think it's just that the way you love changes as you get older. And I think we've never not been in love.
You know, it's acceptance. It's definitely love. There's nothing that he would ever do to make me not love him, ever. There are things that he does that make me really mad, but that doesn't mean I don't love him. It's just a forever thing. We never, ever considered it wouldn't be forever.
I think we're still in love because of our communication. I think in previous relationships, the communication was lacking or non-existent. And I know when we were dating, that was something that was very important to me, that we communicate and we set time aside quarterly, monthly, to just talk about how we feel and what's going on in our relationship, specifically our relationship, not just our lives.
Yeah, I agree. I think communication is definitely key and very important part of it. And yes, I do feel like we are still in love. And it's just that continued affection for one another as well that we have. So I think that goes a long way as well.
If I could fly, I'd be coming right back home.
The relationship has increasingly become this just sort of kind of, not even cohabitating, but like sort of co-surviving, really. Where both of them are hurting, where there's all sorts of wounds that are going unaddressed. And there's sort of this like kind of, probably not spoken, but sort of this understanding, like this Cold War, you know, if I could make a historical analogy, understanding of like, okay, we're just not going to go really too much of any place real. But that kind of place, it can have a fairly strong gravitational pull, because it's like you're still having relationship or it's a semblance of relationship. But you're not going the places you need to go, you know, so there's not a whole lot of like true emotional intimacy. And so it's just like you're playing it safe, but you sort of hate, you know, the state of things, but you don't want to leave because you're still wanting like some tiny bit of connection that you still have, you know. Usually in these kinds of scenarios, there's kids involved. So it's like that's part of the thing.
I never hated you like I do right now.
So in terms of thinking about cheating, you know, it's some kind of seeking, you know, for an answer to some to things that the person doesn't know how to address in themselves. And so in that regard, it has nothing to do with their partner, you know, absolutely nothing, other than the fact that they have been with their partner long enough to discover, oh, you're a human being and not the fantasy I thought you were, and so I need to chase after something else. I need to find another fantasy, another drug, right? Because that's kind of what we're doing. We're sort of, you know, there's a little bit of like, you know, using each other as a drug initially, you know, or sometimes a lot of using each other as a drug. And then, you know, we go through this withdrawals of like, wait, you're human, I don't know about this. So it's a chasing after something, some kind of answer. And so, you know, I mean, part of what I do with folks, I mean, I've worked with lots of people who've had affairs, and, you know, it's just kind of really trying to help them get really honest with themselves about like, what is this really about? You know, it's not really about, you know, that your partner didn't do this, that, or the other, or they do this, that, or the other. Like, those things matter, but those are clues. Those are clues to things that need working and addressing in yourself. Not that that doesn't mean that there aren't things to address relationally. Like, that's where it's tricky and complicated, right? Like, you know, maybe the partner, you know, has a temper, and it's like, you know, and so part of the affair is this, like, avoidance of that and seeking somebody who's going to affirm them, you know? And so it's like, okay, yeah, the conversations about the temper need to happen, but you can't do that constructively until, like, we deal with, like, why your way of handling that is to run off and have an affair, you know? Like, because that's not a real solution. That's not really dealing with anything.
I never needed you like I do right now.
Stay away from each other. No, I'm kidding. No, we play golf. We go out to dinner all the time. We watch TV together. And we also give each other space. She has friends that she's close to, and she does things with them. I have friends, and I do things with them. And I think as you get older in your marriage, and older as a person, you need to have friends too, because that gives you variety, if you will. You can't spend 24 hours every day together. You'll go crazy. So having experiences with friends is important. And I really think that in life in general, as you get older, friends become much, much more important. I mean, it's time to get away from your family. They all go their way. They have their own things to do. They have their lives to live. And you find when you start to get older that friends are very important.
Thank you.
Now, I agree with everything you said, mainly. But in the very beginning of our relationship, although we did have a lot of friends, we did a lot of family stuff. Things that he liked to do, he liked to play golf, I learned how. We both learned how to ski together. And then when we had kids, our kids learned how to ski. Our kids learned how to pick up. We went on vacations as a family all the time.
So we don't really have like a set date night or we have to have like two date nights a week. It's just kind of natural. Every weekend we just, you know, it's like, okay, it's Saturday. We've done our stuff. What do you want to do? You want to?
Right. Yeah.
Want to go get a drink? You want to get dinner? You want to?
Yeah. Look online, see what's going on in the area and pick out something to go do, and whether, yeah, like a brewery, winery, what have you, or a festival that's going on close by or something. So, yeah, and just go in and enjoy each other's time together.
Yeah, but it's just it's more natural. It's not forced. Nobody's like, oh, it's Tuesday, I have to have dinner with my husband. It's not like that. It's just, hey, it's Saturday, let's go out and do something fun
right. Together. Absolutely.
Basically, you know, when you're dating and when you first get married, there's a lot of things that you have to learn about one another. And it takes time. It doesn't happen in 24 hours or 1 year. I mean, it takes time. And during that period, there could be some rocky situations where you're not sure of yourself. But if it's a true, caring relationship, you learn to get over those things. And believe it or not, as time goes by, your love gets deeper and deeper, and you start to understand one another. If that doesn't happen, I think generally speaking, there's where you start to see divorces. You start to find out things about the other person that you didn't really know, and you find yourself in a situation where you don't like it.
I feel a little different. I think that you have to be friends. I think you have to be friends first. I think that the physical aspect is they don't turn you off. But I think you get to know somebody and you really like them. They're really nice. You are friends first. The physical comes later. You have to be attracted, but you don't have to say, oh my God. You know, I know people that'll say, boy, I really love him, but I don't like him. That's terrible. And there are people that stay married like that. Oh, I really love him, but I don't like him. I believe you have to like first.
Okay, so relationship advice I would give. Balance. That, like, I know when I was in my 20s and I was looking for a spouse, a life partner, whatever, I thought I needed to find somebody that met my energy. But looking back now, I shouldn't have been looking for that. I should have been looking for somebody that balanced me, that we complemented each other.
Go ahead and get a good therapist. Yeah, because relationships are wonderfully hard. and as amazing as your partner might seem to you right now, once you've been with them long enough, like, you'll be like, you're a human being. This isn't what I agreed to. Like, you're no, I thought you're gonna be a certain way, and like, and now you're doing this thing that I hate, and how could you do that? I thought you loved me. And and that's, you know, that freaks us out, you know, as that starts to happen. And so we need support.
Say it, baby. I never needed you like I do right now. I never hated you like I do right now. 'Cause all you ever do